The Portuguese came first, but after that, almost every European power tried to get their hands on El Minor at one point because it was a strategic location.
Right.
By the 1700s, the slave trade was the main business going on. So one of the things that most strikes me, Sam, about coming in here is that building.
This part right here?
Yeah, this square bit in the middle. That is a church.
Is this the Protestant church or the Catholic church?
Well, initially it was a Catholic church, but when the British took it over, they continued to use it as a Protestant church. All of these Europeans thought that it was compatible to conduct this absolutely horrific trade in the dungeons of this building. And at the same time, these guys were going into church and saying their prayers every day. One of the things that I think is most upsetting is the kind of sexual abuse that happened here. So in the governor's bedroom, there's a trapdoor in the floor, and it leads through some ladders directly down into the women's dungeon. One of them would be selected and brought straight up to the officer's bedroom, washed, because they were kept in a state of filth down there. And then he would rape her, and he would just have free access to these women and girls.
I'm sure there were little boys who were subjected to the same.
Yeah. This is where people who were enslaved were held until it was time for them to be shipped out onto vessels waiting here. This is the door of no return. And once they passed this point, it was the end of life as they knew it. It was the end of their culture, their names would be changed, they would have a life of forced labor, their children and their children's children would be born into slavery. And so this was really the end of their freedom.
Some people say, oh, don't you feel sorrow when this is? It's still a feeling of anger for me.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. This is what it is. This is man's inhumanity to man, and this is almost like the capital of it.
It is.
Yeah.